Hey now, and happy Friday to you all. This is a special Friday night edition of Brain Party Trivia that is all about, what other topic but Smash Mouth. I'm doing a very special trivia tonight that is all about the band Smash Mouth, and I'm only just doing one quick round of Smash Mouth trivia. Then we're going to do a Smash Mouth Power Hour. If you're not familiar with Power Hour, with what a Power Hour is, it is a drinking game that is going to be entirely Smash Mouth based tonight. And the very exciting thing that I'm happy about is I got not one, but I got two members of the band Smash Mouth to be part of this tonight. I actually got the guy that wrote the song All Star to be part of tonight's trivia, so I'm very excited about that. So if you want to play along, I'm going to start that trivia and Power Hour in just a few minutes. First, I want to play a quick game of Jackbox Trivia, play trivia against you guys before I get started with the Smash Mouth event. So I'm just going to do one round of Smash Mouth Trivia, don't worry, it's not going to be too hard. And then we're going to be playing that Smash Mouth Power Hour, which, like I said, I got two different members of the band Smash Mouth to be a part of. So I'm very, very excited about this. I don't know how this night's gonna go, but hopefully you will play along and we'll have some fun tonight. So to start things off, if you wanna play along with Jackbox, all you gotta do is go to jackbox.tv and enter tonight's room code, which is QIDP. QIDP is the room code for Jackbox Trivia. It's a simple game, trivia game. We're gonna be playing against me. We're gonna answer multiple choice trivia questions all about random topics, and play some mini games in between. So once again, if you want to play along, all you got to do is go to jackbox.tv. It's easiest to play on your phone or a separate device. Grab a tablet, whatever you got. You can even open up a new browser if you're on your laptop there. And enter the room code QIDP. QIDP is the room code. Once we have a couple people, or if nobody's watching, then I'll give you just about 2 minutes, and then I'm going to get started with this little warm-up game. So sit tight, and yeah, we'll get trivia started, like I said, in about 2 minutes with this warm-up. If you want to join along, jackbox.tv, QIDP is the code. I think it's just going to be Yes John, so let's go ahead and play some Jackbox and see if anybody joins in. So this is exciting. Hi, everybody. Oh, Krevins is here. Krevins, are you in Jackbox? Should I? It's too late. You can join the audience and play as them, I guess. Oh, you're yourself. Oh, okay, cool. So we do have a couple people playing. That's exciting. Anyway,
wake up call. Audio going prepare here so to
hear what's going on.
Welcome to Trivia Murder Party. There is no social mixer in our hotel ballroom. You've been lured into a murderous game of trivia. Only one of you will survive. And I hope that one survivor will keep us in mind for their future vacation needs. All right, first question. How long was World War II? Use your device to answer the question. And the correct answer is, who got the question right?
I thought it was 8. Dumb. Well, I'm glad you were able to join us, Chris. I don't know if you heard, but I actually got some of the Smash Meathers to be involved tonight, so I'm very excited about it.
And here are your bags. Welcome to room 105. Hopefully you can defend yourself from ESP. Type in an answer that fits this category. Everyone else will answer too. And if anyone matches you, you die. Write your answers now. Now, let's see if there are any matches. Idiots, I would have guessed that one. I'm not comfortable with silence, so I talk during elevator rides. Let's try another one. Who is the youngest darling in Peter Pan?
You're wrong, Chris. People are actually tuning in now. So if you're just playing along and you want to play some Jackbox with us, just go to jackbox.tv and enter the room code QIDP. Smash Mouth Trivia is starting soon, and we'll have Smash Mouth Power Hour shortly after that.
Welcome to Room 237. This one's just about me giving you a gift. These are precious family treasures I give away as punishments. Pick a box and keep what's inside. Ah, memories. They're the worst. That's my father's hat. I want you to wear it. Hey everybody, look! It's my dad. Don't worry, he won't be alive a whole lot longer.
To everyone just popping in on Twitch, don't worry.
Remember
I'm assuming
LMB
if you got here from
Smash
Mouth, Smash
Mouth
Trivia is
going to
get started pretty shortly
her,
here.
But with more murder. Let's keep moving. Which of these movie monsters does not kill anybody?
Like this is a loaded question.
Who picked this? Which leaves only you. And it's like totally my dad. I want to show you something. It's my old favorite, chalices. I've given each safe player a poison pellet. Pick a chalice to drop your poison in. Now it's your turn to play. Pick a chalice to drink from. Oh. Yummy. Now let's see what everyone drank. It worked! I love it when it works. I'll kill you, Daddy!
Looks like yourself is dead. It's just me and John left.
Your death doesn't mean that hat
with
has to leave
Smash
the game.
Mouth trivia shortly
There's a
after.
Wheel on your controller right now, and you have a few seconds to bequeath it to another player. But you gotta do it fast. We're not done with you yet. Remember, dead players are still players, just more see-through. Keep playing, and you just might steal someone else's life force and win the game. Now that I've defeated my dad, I don't know what to do with myself. What? You're back? I'll stop you again, father. We're here. When one player is left alive, we'll go to the final round. Next question. Which word does not appear in the Queen song, Bohemian Rhapsody? Oh. almost out of time. Who picked this? But I refuse to acknowledge a reality where you're right, Father. Time for consequences.
So we got a lot of people on Twitch that are not playing. You can join in the audience and play along anytime you want by going to jackbox.tv and entering that room code on the
Follow
bottom.
Follow as many rules as you can before time runs out. Everyone else is playing too. If any of them correctly follow more rules than you, I will kill you. Go! Sometimes I worry that I say the word rules too much during this game. Rules, rules, rules. Yeah, maybe I'm overthinking it. Almost out of rules time! There's always someone out there better at following rules.
God damn it, Chris. Alright, it looks like John's the only one left, and then I'm getting started with Smash Mouth trivia.
Only one of you is still alive. You know what that means. Glad to see you're the one to make it here alive, but will you be the one to escape? I'm going to give you a category. Poems that rhyme. Tap each answer that fits the category, and then press, let's see the right answers. You advance one space for every correct answer. You're a little bit closer to escaping, but you're not alone in here. If a ghost catches up with you, they will steal your life force. Then they can escape and win the game. Here's everyone's next question. And ghosts get a third choice to help them catch up to you. Time is up. Kind of a gimme. Ranks of organisms and taxonomy. Time is almost up. Here comes the next question. Fellowship members in Fellowship of the Ring. What I had in mind.
Well, this is fun.
Don't fall behind. Here comes the darkness. Arthropods. Ghosts can smell your life force. Contains peanuts. Time is almost up. That one was too easy. Not so fast. If you want to break through that barrier, you'll need a perfect answer to this question. And that includes the third answer choice now, too. Time is almost up. The tables have turned. Moving on. Overwatch characters. You have to get all the right answers to escape. Another life swap. Practices of the Buddhist Eightfold Path.
What? How does Chris win? We tied on that one. That's baloney. I don't like it. All right, well, that's going to do it for the warm-up. We're playing Smash Mouth Trivia now. If you want to play along with Smash Mouth Trivia, exit out of Jackbox and go to crowd.live. Crowd.live is the room code on... is the website to go to for this one. And the room code is Z-W-E-Z-Z. Z-W-E-Z-Z is the room code for our Smash Mouth Trivia. I can't not giggle whenever I say that. I love that this is happening. Yes, Smash Mouth Trivia is going to get started in just a couple minutes. I think it's just me, John, and Chris, unless there's a few more people out there in internet Twitch world that are watching but not participating. Maybe they're just waiting along for the power hour to start after trivia. Smash Mouth Trivia. We're just going to do one round of Smash Mouth Trivia, and then I'm doing a Smash Mouth Power Hour, where I'm going to play 60 different clips of 60 different Smash Mouth songs that are all 60 seconds in length, and for each one, we're all going to do a shot of beer and see what happens at the end of it, or if we can make it through. And also, I got not one, but two members of the band Smash Mouth, including the guy that wrote All Star himself, to participate in this trivia, so I'm very excited about it. Round number one, the only round of Smash Mouth Trivia, is going to get started in, I'm just going to do 3-minute timer, get my beers ready for the power hour, because I think that's really what we're all here for. So if you want to play along with Smash Mouth Trivia, just go to crowd.live. You can see at the bottom of your screen the black bar there. Go to crowd.live and enter the room code Z-W-E-Z-Z. Z-W-E-Z-Z. I know I'm seeing those numbers go up and down on Twitch. There are multiple people watching that are not participating, so don't be shy. Play along in the game. You don't worry. You're not on camera or anything. You're just answering questions. Round number one, the only round of Smash Mouth Trivia, is going to get started in about 3 minutes. Immediately following that, we're doing Smash Mouth Power Hour, which is an updated version, John. I fixed all the sound issues in the last one and added some new clips, and of course added clips with the band. Smash Mouth Trivia is going to get started in about 3 minutes. I'm going to go get my beers ready for Smash Mouth Power Hour right after. I'm very excited to see who knows more about Smash Mouth Trivia between John and Krevins. But there's still like 4 other people watching that are not signed in. So unless you're Universal Music, even if you are a Universal Music lawyer, you can still play along. Let's go to crowd.live and enter the room code at Z-W-E-Z-Z. Our only round of Smash Mouth Trivia is getting started in just about a minute. Normally trivia is, type in the answer. These are going to be multiple choice, but still fast as fingers. The quicker you answer, the more points you will get. Just going to do 10 quick questions, and then we'll do our Smash Mouth Power Hour. I extend out to you. All right, first round of Smash Mouth trivia is getting started right now. Round number one, it's Smash Mouth. Question number one, multiple choice. We got a third player now. What was the title of Smash Mouth's first single? What was the title of Smash Mouth's first single for question number one? Was it All Star, I'm a Believer, Then the Morning Comes, or Why Can't We Be Friends? What was the title of their first single, their debut single? Question number one. So question number one for round number one. What was the title of Smash Mouth's first single? I screwed up here, but I didn't screw up too bad, so it's all good. I was looking for Walking on the Sun was actually their first single, but I messed up on typing that in. But that doesn't matter, because out of those four, their earliest, their second single, the earliest out of those four was Why Can't We Be Friends? So it doesn't matter there. Question number two. Number two, it's a cool place, and they say it gets colder. But judging by the hole in the satellite picture, who begs to differ, according to the lyrics of All Star? Question number two, was it the Meteor Men, the news media, the rocket scientists, or the salty dogs? It's a cool place, and they say it gets colder, but judging by the hole in the satellite picture, who begs to differ, according to the lyrics of All Star? Burning sun will someday rise. So what am I gonna be doing for a while? Said I'm gonna play with myself. Show them now we've come off the shelf. Question number two. Who begged to differ? The correct answer. It was the Meteor Men begged to differ, judging by the hole in the satellite picture. Only 66% of the teams got that one right. Moving on to question number three. Number three on our Smash Mouth round. Who was the lead singer of Smash Mouth? Who was the lead singer of Smash Mouth? Is it Greg Camp, Jason Sutter, Paul Delisle, or Steve Harwell? Who is the lead singer of the band Smash Mouth? For our trivia round on Smash Mouth before we get started with Power Hour. Question number three. All you had to do was tell me who the lead singer of Smash Mouth is. We got some mouth heads out there. Everybody knew that is Steve Harwell. Question number four. Number four is a fun one because I'm not going to be asking this question. No, I got a special guest quizmaster that is going to pop in and ask this question for you. Here's question number four on our Smash Mouth trivia.
What's up, guys? This is Sean Hurwitz, guitarist from Smash Mouth, and I thought I'd pop in and ask one of tonight's trivia questions. By the way, for more exclusive Smash Mouth clips, please check out my YouTube page. I'll make sure Nick leaves a link below. Okay, so you can see the band in animated form performing the song Come On, Come On at the Middleton Mad Dog Ball in an episode of what former Disney series?
All right, that was question number four for round number one. I forgot to put the link in there, but that was youtube.com/C/Steve Hurwitz Music. I will put that in the Twitch chat so everybody can go along and follow Steve Hurwitz. He's a great guy. Very excited that he was able to help out with tonight's trivia. And I did include the link in, maybe he'll pop up later in the night, but I forgot to include it on that one. But yeah, go ahead and follow Steve Hurwitz Music on YouTube. I just put the link in the chat for you there. That is question number four. Smash Mouth performed the song Come On, Come On at the Middleton Mad Dog Ball in an episode of what former Disney series? The correct answer is Kim Possible. How many people got that one right? Only two of y'all got that one. Here is question five. Halfway through our Smash Mouth round, question number five. What was the title of Smash Mouth's first album? What was the title of Smash Mouth's first album? Was it Astro Lounge, Fush You Meng, Get the Picture, or Smash Mouth? Question number five. What was the title of Smash Mouth's first album? Was it Astro Lounge, Fush You Meng, Get the Picture, or was it simply titled Smash Mouth? That's question number five, halfway through our Smash Mouth trivia. Then we're getting started with Smash Mouth Power Hour. Hopefully y'all stick around for that. This was a tricky one. I'm surprised only about 30% of you mouthheads out there knew that the first album released by the band was called Fush You Meng. Fush You Meng was where it all began. Here is question number six. Number six, they've done a lot, but what was the first cover song that was released by the band? Once again, they've done a lot of them. They've done quite a few cover songs, but which one was the first released by the band? Was it Can't Get Enough of You, Baby, Don't You Forget About Me, I'm a Believer, or Why Can't We Be Friends? Question number six on our Smash Mouth trivia. Little trivia introduction to the band before we do our 60-minute power hour. 60 different 60-second clips of the band Smash Mouth tonight. And for each one, I'm going to be taking a shot of beer. Hopefully you are playing along with me. This is question number six for our 10-question trivia before power hour starts. I tripped up a few more of y'all than I thought. Question number six. They've done a lot, but what was the first cover song released by the band? That would be Why Can't We Be Friends. Why Can't We Be Friends was the first cover that they released. Question number seven. Number seven. What band originally released the song Why Can't We Be Friends? Question seven. To tie into our sixth question. Question number seven. What band originally released the song Why Can't We Be Friends for question seven? That is it A, question mark and the Mysterians, B, Pororo, C, Simple Minds, or D, War? Which one originally released the song Why Can't We Be Friends? Just because they did it first doesn't mean they did it best. That is question seven for round, our only round of Smash Mouth Trivia. Why Can't We Be Friends, originally released by the band War. War. What is good for? Absolutely nothing. Question number eight. Number eight, what was the name of the Smash Mouth holiday album that was released in December of 2005? It was on repeat in my house this Christmas, and I gotta tell you, it's not that bad. It is my favorite rock Christmas album. Anything's better than Mariah Carey. Don't hate me for that. Question number eight. What was the name of the Smash Mouth holiday album released in December 2005? Was it Christmas Portrait, December, The Gift of Rock, or Santa Mental? Oh,
have sell out with me tonight. The record company's gonna give me lots of money and everything's gonna be all right.
I gotta say, I am both shocked and severely disappointed that nobody picked Santimental. I was really hoping that was gonna happen. The correct answer, The Gift of Rock, is the best rock Christmas album, probably of all time. Here's question number nine. Number nine, only two questions left. Question number nine, actually, I'm not gonna ask this one. Let's see who we got. I think we got a guest host that is gonna ask this question.
Hey y'all, this is Greg Camp, one of the founding members. I was a guitarist and songwriter for the band Smash Mouth. And I'm popping by to ask tonight's trivia question. The official music video for All Star includes references to what 1999 superhero comedy film featuring Ben Stiller and Hank Azaria?
So you heard it from the man himself, Greg Camp, the writer of the song All Star. I'm so excited that he was able to help us out with this. Question number nine. The official music video for All Star includes references to what 1999 superhero comedy film featuring Ben Stiller and Hank Azaria? Was it Mystery Men, Sky High, Stardog and Turbo Cat, or Teen Titans Go? That is question nine. Only one question left before we get this Power Hour started. I think almost everybody knows this one, though. Yeah, you know your Smash Mouth. This is some 101, but I still had to ask it. Mystery Men is the correct answer, and here is question number 10. Final question for our Smash Mouth trivia, question number 10. It's famously associated with Shrek and Mystery Men, but what Matthew Broderick film was the first to feature the song All Star? Was it Election, Godzilla, Inspector Gadget, or The Lion King 2, Simba's Pride? Once again, which one was the first to feature the song All Star? First film released, Election, Godzilla, Inspector Gadget, or The Lion King 2, Simba's Pride? All right, question number 10, 10th and final question of Smash Mouth Trivia. It's famously associated with Shrek and Mystery Men, but what Matthew Broderick film was the first that featured the song All Star? I think everybody knew that was Inspector Gadget. Let's see who our big winner is. Small night tonight, but Booty Giuliani is our Smash Mouth champion. Congratulations to Booty Giuliani. Mike Oxard, not too shabby, in second place. And Krug, always a pleasure to see you here. Thanks for joining us, Krug. You finished in third, unfortunately. Booty Giuliani, I'm sorry, Chris, but I ain't buying you nothing because nobody donated nothing. We only had three teams, but that's all right because we got a lot of people that are tuning in on Twitch, and I'm about to start some Power Hour. Smash Mouth Power Hour. So if you are not familiar with how Power Hour works, what's going to happen is I'm going to play 60 different 60-second clips of Smash Mouth songs. All 60 clips tonight are all going to be Smash Mouth, and I'm going to take a shot of beer for each one. Hopefully you do as well, and we'll see how we're feeling towards the end of the night. Remember, I still got more appearances from the group coming up in Smash Mouth Power Hour. I'm going to get this started probably just now. I mean, if that's cool with you guys. So, 60 different 60-second clips, all about Smash Mouth. Shot of beer for each one. If you want to play along, get your cans ready. And, yeah, let's just go ahead and listen to some Smash Mouth tunes, shall we? All right, so let's start this thing off.
All right, state your name and power.
Actually, I'm not ready to start it off yet. I wanna do this in a different way because I can't hear it the way it's set up right now. Normally I would never do this, but since it's just Chris and John, I love you guys, but I'm gonna try to do it in a way where I can hear what's going on as well. So sit tight. And I will have Smash Mouth Power Hour kicked off in just a second. Alright, I think I am ready. Let's do a window capture. that's the wrong source. Also the wrong source. Yeah, no, that's weird. All right, how do I do this? Sorry. Smash Mouth trivia is coming up in just a second. Or not trivia, we just did trivia. Chris won trivia. We're trying to do Power Hour now. But I'm trying to figure out how to make the source visible. Maybe? Can y'all see that? No? Alright, whatever. I guess it doesn't matter. I don't need to see this. Alright, so Smash Mouth Power Hour, 60 different clips all about the band Smash Mouth is getting started in just a second. So, yeah, make sure you have some beers and a shot glass ready. Fellas, I don't know about y'all, but I'm going to do a whiskey for our first shot. So feel free to pour yourself one of those if you would like to. Never had this issue before. Not sure why it's happening now. But I'm going to give it one more try before I just go ahead and do it. So if you want to play along, pour yourself a whiskey for our first shot, which is going to get started in just a moment. And yes, Chris, I will tell Smash Mouth that a lawyer named Booty Giuliani won their trivia night. Lorma is in the house! What's up, Lorma? Oh, I'll miss you, baby girl. We're about to get started with Power Hour right now. I'm just having a small issue trying to figure out some audio stuff. I don't know if that's working. No, this thing just hates me, I guess. All right, well, whatever. I guess I don't need to see the Power Hour. Whatever. All right, so let's go ahead and get this Power Hour thing started. Here is your mom. I miss Diane. Diane. Yeah, she's a sweetheart. She's a babe, man. If I was like 5 years younger, I swear. Never mind. Don't tell your dad I said that. Here's right, Smash Mouth Power Hour. Starting things off with shot
with my griddle of justice,
me.
I bash the enemy in the head,
intro,
or
but let's
I burn
have
them
fun.
Like so.
Cheers, everybody.
Next.
Hi. I am Pencilhead.
And I am son of Pencilhead.
We erase crime.
Two generations of.
Right.
Yes. Thank you.
I'd say there's potential.
Somebody once told me the who's Pocket Grandpa? Saw True Crime on the notifications. I did True Crime on Wednesday and forgot to update the information there. John, why are you asking? How many Smash Mouth guys are playing? There are two that helped out with trivia. There's only gonna be one that helped out with Power Hour. Alright, so that was our first song. Let's do another one. So cheers, everybody. 60 different 60-second clips all about Smash Mouth. Doing a shot of beer for each one, and probably a shot of whiskey. At we started with one. I'll probably do the whiskey at 30 and 60, maybe 50 and 45. We'll see how I feel tonight. Why Can't We Be Friends? One of their classics that we learned was originally by War. Wait, is Pocket Grandpa Warma? I got confused about the name. There's a lot of people watching on Twitch, actually. Hopefully, oh no, Lorma is Rolla. Pocket Grandpa, is that Cruz? I don't know. But yeah, apparently we got a lot of people watching on Twitch, so that's kind of cool. Remember when your mom won a bonus question by saying, I do not remember that, but I'm
did you like Smash Mouth?
Sure that happened, and I love that your mom won that way. Alright, this is our second Smash Mouth song. Cheers, everybody. Oh yeah, the Paul Rudd trivia night. Yeah, I totally remember that. Your brother got really mad at me because he didn't know that I knew you, and he just thought I came up to your table and started eating your pizza. I think that was the same night. That was pretty fun. Oh no, I think that might have been Friends trivia. It was right around Thanksgiving, I remember. But Paul Rudd trivia was pretty fun. Oh, this is a classic. Originally written by Steve Harwell, the lead singer of Smash Mouth, later covered by the Jackson 5. Okay, it was Paul Rudd trivia. Yeah, I remember that. Somebody once told me the world is gonna roll me. I ain't the sharpest tool in the shed. This is a great song. You may remember this from the first song I played, All-Star from the film Mystery Men. That was the original version. Here's question number three. Or not question. Let's see what song this is. Okay, switching it up a little bit so it's not just All-Star the whole time. Oh, I forgot to drink though. Cheers, everybody. Make sure to tell me if you catch me not drinking, because I'm very forgetful of that. This is a love attack. I know what went out its back. It's just like any fat. I know, I really wanted to do nothing but 60 different actual Smash Mouth music videos, but unfortunately they only released about 9. So, a good 85% of tonight's trivia, or tonight's Power Hour, is going to be songs more inspired by the group than actually. Oh, this is a fun one. Cat in the Hat, great movie. Terribly inappropriate for children. And I always thought it was Beans from Even Stevens that played the little kid in it, but I was wrong when I assumed that. Sense, but you keep on looking. Cheers, everybody. They tell you to be true. You're trying every day to keep it on the real. Still, you gotta find a way to make your mama happy. But Beans was the kid in, I think it was a Pearl Jam music video. Gather around, I can't remember now. No, Marilyn Manson music video. Little Beans, weird kid. From Even Stevens. Yeah, his first role was in a Marilyn Manson music video. It was very awkward to notice that after the fact. Alright, next song. Cheers, everybody. This is a classic song by the group Smash Mouth. One of their darker hits. Wasn't popularized until the mid-2000s. Hopefully I'll get better at this one as I get more drunk. Hopefully y'all are playing along with me with this Power Hour thing. I see there's actually not a bad amount of viewers. We're in the double digits. We're in the double digits now for a little bit. So, that's fun. Still plenty of Smash Mouth left to go. Who did sing that song, I'm Just a Kid? I'm just a kid, my whole life. I don't remember. Alright, looks like we're on our sixth Smash Mouth video. Oh, this is a classic. This is actually from a theme song they did in the early 90s. On NBC from 1992 to 1996. It featured the famous actor Alfonso Rubio as the Simple Plan, that's who it was. Thank you, Pocket Grandpa, for letting me know that.
just sit right there. I'll tell you how
this show also featured the voice of a cartoon's Shredder from the Ninja Turtles. R.I.P. to that man. Great actor. Fun fact, Steve Harwell actually never made an appearance in the show, despite being a big fan. Day after day, but she packed my suitcase and sent me on my way. She gave me a kiss and then she gave me my ticket. I put my Walkman on. All right, cheers, everybody.
Gotta relax.
This is Earth Radio.
All right, I'm going to turn this off on my personal Facebook page because I think I have family on there and I'm probably going to get a little drunk. You request the version where it just keeps getting faster. We'll see what I can do for you later on. There are 60 different Smash Mouth clips in this, so you never know what you're going to get. Somebody once told me the world is going to roll me. Forrest Gump mashup. Maybe I'll try to make one of those. She was looking kind of dumb with Kravins, I'm amazed you've never played this before. Like, I specifically brought this Power Hour or a prior version of it on a flash drive to your bachelor party so we could play it there. And nobody else wanted to play it, and I was very upset. Whoops, it wasn't time to drink. Oh, I guess I just did actually. You'll never know if you don't go. You'll never shine if you don't glow. Hey now, you're an I also wish I could just get all you guys on camera so we could play the all-star one word at a time game. All right, clip number 8. Yes, we know you hate that game, John. But we love it. This is a famous Smash Mouth clip. I believe this one was written by Paul DeLisle. Alongside Quincy Jones, and then later given to an aspiring young artist. His name was MC Scat Cat. Because I don't know how to put you on camera, Rolla. If you would have told me this like an hour ago, I could have typed you in. This ain't Zoom though. But that's all right. Just talk to me in the chat, and I'll play along. We can still drink together. Although I do miss your party face. I would tell you to come to Austin soon, but, you know, there ain't nothing anywhere right now. All right, what do we got next? Cheers, everybody.
Did you like Smash Mouth?
Your watch stops time?
That is way too much work, Kravins. Maybe I'll start a stream yard. Alright, I'm gonna try to, I'm gonna try to make this happen for y'all. Cheers, everybody.
We move toward a new world order. A normal life is boring. The superstardom close to post-mortem. It only grows harder. Homie grows hotter. He blows. It's all over. These hoes is all on him. Coast to coast shows. He's known as the Globetrotter. Lonely roads got only knows he's